Welcome back to another edition of Comic Book Flashback. I'm Marvel the Cross 316, and today we are looking at Fantastic Four, issue number 14. This issue came out in May of 1963, and today we are seeing the return of Namor the Submariner. But we're not also only seeing the return of Namor, but we're also going to see the return of the Puppet Master. Now, if you watched my video on my review for Fantastic Four issue number 8, we saw the first appearance of the Puppet Master, and we also thought that he had died, but apparently the Puppet Master is actually still alive. And so today we're going to be looking at a pretty cool tale here. Submariner taking Sue Storm's hostage, and so we got a lot going on. We have part one, Submariner and the Merciless Puppet Master. This issue is brought to you by Stan Lee, Jack Kirby, Dick Ayers, and then, of course, Art Zemeck here. And so we start out with part one here. We had the Fantastic Four returning back to Earth. They had just fought the Red Ghost and his Super Apes, remember from last issue, and they were able to defeat basically the Red Ghost and the Super Apes. And they were the first Earthlings to basically be successful in returning back to Earth from the moon. And so everybody is waiting down below. I mean, there is a huge crowd, a huge gathering, and we're going to see basically all of these fans for the Fantastic Four waiting to see them come back to Earth here. I mean, this is a huge deal. We see that the Thing is controlling the Fantastic Four jet, and there's a smooth landing here. All the Fantastic Four members are looking out the window, and they're like, wow, this is just so exciting. Look at this, all this big gathering here. So the Fantastic Four return back to the Earth successfully, and they are immediately, I mean, just surrounded by all their fans. Mr. Fantastic surrounded by so many beautiful girls here. And then we have the Thing here who's challenged by this wrestler here, and he makes really short work with this guy. Throws him right to a trash can. We have these guys come up to the Invisible Girl asking her if she wants to get on some kind of Hollywood contract. So we see that Human Torch has had enough, and he basically forms this warm air suction vacuum, causing all of the members to be basically suctioned up into this vacuum, and they're basically teleported right towards the Baxter Building. So they were able to avoid all of the fans and just all of the paparazzi, basically. So the Fantastic Four return back to their nice room here, and they are just beat. I mean, they have been on one mission after the next. Later on in the day, Mr. Fantastic is working on some scientific reports for NASA and about rocket fuel, basically. And he comes across the Invisible Girl, and she's basically staring off into space here. And Mr. Fantastic knows what she's thinking about. She's thinking about Namor the Submariner. And we see here that Reed Richards, he knows how fantastic he really is. I mean, he's been able to use his powers for good, for the good of mankind. He's a super genius. He's created so many different kinds of gadgets that just are amazing here. But the one thing he's not been able to do is to win the heart of the girl that he loves. And so, you know, Sue Storms basically has a lot of thinking to do. She still, in a way, still likes Namor, but she also likes Reed Richards. So she's kind of confused. So now we're going to see how our next villain here, who is basically the Puppet Master, he's in disguise. He's been in hiding. We thought that he had died when he fell off the roof that time in issue number 8, but in fact he did not. And so now we see the Puppet Master is going to form this new plan here, which is to use Namor the Submariner as his bidding here. So while Namor the Submariner is still trying to find remains of his lost people, he all of a sudden is controlled by the Puppet Master here. And instantly we see here that Namor the Submariner is going to summon none other than Sue Storms here. And so she's going to sneak out without the others knowing. She meets up with Namor at the pier. And we see here that Namor is being controlled by this hypnotic eye here, this fish. And this fish basically forms an airtight bubble. And now they go back to under the sea. So step one of Puppet Master's plan has been in fruition now. And now it's time for step two. This time the Fantastic Four are going to be able to use some of their free will to go and track down the Submariner. But this is basically the Puppet Master's plan here, is to defeat, to utterly defeat the Fantastic Four. And so all of a sudden, the Fantastic Four come across a astral image of the Submariner here. That's one of his powers that he's able to do. Basically, Submariner tells the Fantastic Four that he has the Invisible Girl prisoner with him, and if they have the guts, come and meet him undersea. So the Fantastic Four get into their submarine here, and also we see that what we're going to see is the Puppet Master is also going to form his own submarine. But before they get started, we have a lot of things they have to clear in as well. So the Human Torch and Mr. Fantastic are going to meet with the police commissioner first to get the key and just to get the okay. And then we see that the Thing is going to meet up with Alicia Masters, his girlfriend. And so we see that the Thing gets in an altercation here with the guy. You got to basically park your car and pay. And so he's been charged double the rate here. He meets up with Alicia. Alicia's sad. She doesn't want him to go. So we see the Thing is going to carry along Alicia Masters on this mission. And the Thing loses his temper here by piling up all these cars here. And he said, "You're not going to tell me what to do." But we see later on that he basically put the cars back in place. So we see the Thing is expecting Mr. Fantastic to complain about bringing Alicia Masters on this mission. But instead, we see that he's okay with it. And so as they get into their submarine here with Alicia Masters, they're on the search for Namor and Sue Storms here, when all of a sudden they're going to be confronted by a lot of attacks here. First, this undersea porcupine, then next, an underwater tornado. We see the Human Torch is going to basically stop the underwater tornado by flaming on here, causing the current to return back to normal. Mr. Fantastic saves the Human Torch, and then we see the last thing that traps the Fantastic Four for good is this underwater giant clam. And we see that it basically used the chloroform vapors to knock out the Fantastic Four. Now the Fantastic Four are going to have to meet up and fight the Submariner, who is still under the control of the Puppet Master. We see that the Human Torch is going to go up first against Namor, but he's going to be immediately defeated as Namor used this a weapon that absorbs heat. Thing is next, and the Thing is now going to be confronted by a spitball that causes his entire body to be enveloped with this fungus. We see that the Thing basically breaks the fungus off of his body, and Reed Richards is next up to the plate to try to stop Namor. So a lot of action taking place. The Thing is going to then go into that tank here to save basically the Invisible Girl, and he's confronted by that giant octopus who's been trying to get after Sue Storms. We see that the Thing is going to cause the mindless creature to run away, and the Thing is able to save the Invisible Girl. So it looks like basically the Puppet Master is going to have to crank it up a notch here, because it looks like the Fantastic Four are able to hold themselves up against Namor here. And so basically the Puppet Master orders Namor to basically kill the Fantastic Four. And so we see the Namor gets it looks like some type of weapon here that causes gas to come out. It's like some kind of plant. And for the first time ever, Namor is struggling here. He doesn't want to kill the girl that he loves, which is basically Sue Storms. He doesn't want to do that. And so, but instead, he still unleashes the gas fumes. He thinks, wait a minute, they're not falling down. These are lethal fumes. We see that Reed Richards always comes prepared. He had flexogen packets that they placed over their faces. We see that Sue Storms gets in the middle, says, no, 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 wait, wait. Listen, he was under the control of basically the pup master. We got to let him go, okay? All of a sudden, we see the octopus breaks loose here, causing a lot of the ocean water to come into that room that they're in. And that octopus is now going to go after the puppet master. The puppet master tries to form a clay model of the octopus. But one thing he didn't think about is that he cannot control something that barely has a mind. And so we see that the puppet master now has to be confronted by that octopus. Namor comes back to, he tells them, look, Sue, have you come back to see me? Are you going to live with me now? She says no. She's still trying to make her final choice. And Namor says, look, I'm still trying to find my missing people, but when I do, you better get ready. All of y'all better get ready, because I'm going to declare war against the surface world. And so we see that the Fantastic Four leave Namor's realm here. But this is not going to be the last time that the Fantastic Four go up against Namor or the Puppet Master. That's a fact. And so we'll be looking at issue number 15 coming up next. And until next time, keep reading comics.